अस्सलाम वालेकुम स्टूडेंट्स, हाउ आर यू ऑल? होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर ओके. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल आई वुड लाइक टू चेक योर होमवर्क व्हिच आई असाइंड यू ऑन ट्यूसडे एंड वेंसडे. ऑन ट्यूसडे आई असाइंड यू दैट यू हैव टू डू वर्ड्स मीनिंग्स एंड क्वेश्चन आंसर्स इन योर इंग्लिश ए नोटबुक्स. And on Wednesday, I assigned you that you have to do workbook page 48. It's exercise 4 will be done. So it was your homework. First of all, I would check your homework words, meanings, and question answers. Your English notebooks, student book, workbook, pencil, and eraser must be with you. So hurry up, beta. I am giving you 1 minute. Within a minute, arrange all these things. I will check your English A notebooks, words, meanings, and question answers. Your student book, workbook, your pencil, eraser, your stationery must be with you. Yes, Varaj. Beta, show me your homework. Yes, Varaj. Who will show me homework first? Raise your hand. Hurry up. Raise your hand. Yes, Zainab. Zainab will show. Yes, Zainab, show me your homework. English A notebook. Words, meanings. Words, meanings, and question answers. Words, meanings.
तो मैंने आपको ये कहना था कि वो जिस क्लास का आप होमवर्क बात कर रही है ना, वो वाली क्लास का तो हमें लिंक ही नहीं आया था जिससे हम क्लास ओपन करते हैं.
बेटा, I sent you a file. In that file, words meanings were written, question answers were written. You just have to copy them in your notebook. Okay, you will see it again. Now, next student.
मैं अब कुछ नहीं कर सकता, जो मर्जी करो.
Thank you.
Yes, teacher. Teacher?
Meu teste 20.
हेलो माइक टेस्टिंग 1 2 3 ये बड़े मुंह वाले कौन है और बड़े मुंह वाली इज्जत पहले की हुआ Hi.
My testing.
तो बहुत आ रही है
नहीं आ रही
क्यों नहीं आ रही मैं पागल बड़े मुंह वाला ये टीचर कहाँ गई है ये बड़ा टीचर कहाँ गई है
ओके ज़ैनब
यस
ज़ैनब रीड थर्ड सेंटेंस
क्या कौन सी बुक का
बेटा इट इज रिटन ऑन द स्क्रीन आई हैव टोल्ड यू लैंग्वेज ट्री वर्कबुक यूनिट 12 पेज 48 एक्सरसाइज 4 हरि आप बेटा
जरा आपकी पहले आवाज ही नहीं आ रही
नाउ यू आर लिसनिंग टू मी ना
यस
ओके यूनिट 12 वर्कबुक पेज 48 Exercise 4.
मैं निकाल लिया.
Okay. Page 48.
निकाल लिया. ये sentence number 2.
3. Sentence number 3. Have you done sentence number 2, Zainab?
No.
Okay. Do it. They traveled to the nature reserve. In first blank, you will be writing 2. Write there 2. After traveled, you have to write 2. Because 2 is telling direction. They traveled to the nature reserve by bus. By bus. Rest of the students will also
the
be doing
bus.
By bus.
The bus stop, the bus stopped dash
bus
the
stopped.
Natural
bus stopped. The bus stopped.
The bus stopped. Dash the nature reserve.
The bus stopped. nature reserve.
Reserve near the nature reserve. In this blank, you will be writing near. Yashad, Maraj.
Near. Near.
Manahid, Ibra. Write in third blank, near. The bus stop near the nature reserve. Fourth sentence. Then read fourth sentence now.
They walk. Walk. Dash the boardwalk. Dash the swim up. Swim. Swim.
Swim. They walked on. They walked on. The first blank.
They walked on.
The fourth sentence. They walked on the boardwalk. Around, around, A-R-O-U-N-D, around the swamp. Around the swamp. Beta, swamp is wetland.
This is the gila land, where is swamp?
Yes. Now I will be asking Ibra. Yes, Ibra.
They saw a monkey climbing on the tree.
In a tree. Climbing in a tree.
Oh.
They saw a monkey climbing in a tree. Now read next sentence. Number six. They watched. Ibra, unmute your mic.
Yes.
They watch the macaws
flying
inside, flying inside aviary. Flying inside the aviary, inside. Done? Yashad, have you written? Zainab, Manahit. Do write it, beta. Do write it. Maraj, Dua, Ibra. Please do write it. And the last sentence is, I'm going to read the last sentence. There were mangroves, dash the boardwalk and the swamp around the boardwalk. In the last blank, you will be writing around. In the last blank, you will be writing around the boardwalk and swamp. Now, I'm going to tell you meanings of all these words. Wait. It is macaws. You can see on the screen. Look at the screen, beta. Look at the screen. Macaws is a brightly colored bird of parrot family. It looks like parrot. It's a brightly colored bird. Then nature reserve. I told you about nature reserve. An area of land. It is protected by, it is protected in order to keep safe the animals and plants, where animals and plants are protected. An area of land where animals and plants are protected and they live there. Boardwalk. This is boardwalk. You can see. It is made of wood. Wooden planks are used. It is called boardwalk. Wood is used in it. A path made of wooden boards. Boardwalk. Swamp. Swamp is wetland. You can see in the picture. Who was asking me? I think Zainab was asking me about swamp. Yes, Zainab, you can see. It's wetland. Mangroves. Mangroves looks like this. A shrub or small tree that grows in coastal area. Aviary. Look at this word. It is a place for keeping birds or a large cage for keeping birds. You can see these are two pictures, and in these two pictures there are two cages. So birds are kept here. Got it? Okay. Now we are going to do, close your workbook, students. Close your workbook. Close your workbook. Now you are going, you will just listen to me. You are going to do email writing. Okay, Zainab, good beta. I have seen. All of you will close your workbook. Okay, look at this slide on the screen. Email writing. Now you have to listen to me very carefully. Email writing, what is the, in email writing, you have to write an email to a member of your family. You are going to do creative writing. So just listen to me first. You are going to do creative writing. Just listen to me first. Write an email to a member of your family. Give him or her details about your plans for a family reunion. Family reunion. Reunion means a planned gathering of family members. This is the meaning of reunion. Look at the screen. This is the meaning of reunion. A planned gathering of family members. Means if you want to gather somewhere, you will inform other family members that we are going to gather at that place, and then you all will be there at the specific day. Okay, what is an email? Look at the screen. Email stands for electronic mail. Email stands for electronic mail. There are two types of email, formal email and formal email and informal email. Okay, look at informal email. Informal is email are written to relatives and friends, and formal emails are written to offices for business purpose and to authorities. Like if you are writing an email to Prime Minister, then or Chief Minister, then those are the authorities. You will be writing email to them. Have you got the difference? Informal email is written to relatives and friends, and formal email is written to for offices, for business purpose, and to authorities. Okay, I have told you meaning of reunion means a planned gathering of family members. Okay, this is the format of an email. First of all, you will be writing here date. Look at the screen, beta. First of all, you will be writing here date, first one. And in the second line, in the second row, you will be writing from. If there is from, then you will be writing your email address. After from, you will be writing your email address. And after to, you will be writing the email address to the person whom you are going to, or you are going to write email address of the person to whom you are sending email. And then subject will be mentioned here, that is family reunion. Okay, I am giving you 1 minute. Just think about the points. What will you be asking your family member, that what we are going to do there, and how will you come there, and what will we be doing there? Just think about a few points. I will be asking you points. Look at the screen. After two, you will be writing receiver's email address, after from, sender's email address, after subject, subject is family reunion, as I have told you, salutation is next part, salutation. Dear sister, dear uncle, dear cousin, or dear brother. Then you will be writing message. After message, there is closing. Hope to see you there soon. Closing can be done in these words. Hope to see you there soon. There mean the place which you have selected, which you have chosen. Signature, then you will be writing your name. Okay. Ibrahim, I'm going to ask you, what will you be writing in the message? As the email is about family reunion. Hurry up, Ibra. Just think about it.
Teacher thought that we should gather all the family and go to the social order box.
Okay, we are going to gather at, for example, Kagan Valley.
Yeah, and
we will be having a lot of fun there. It will be a wonderful occasion. It will be a wonderful event.
Then
we are going
go
to have fun there.
And we can go hiking.
Yes, we can go there for boating and hiking. Good. Okay, now I'm asking Zainab. Zainab, tell me a few points about it. When you are writing an email to a member of a family and you are asking him or her that you have to come here for family reunion at this place, for example, at Kagan Valley, so which words or which sentences you will be using here in the message? Yes, Anna, which words or sentences you will be using here in the message?
आवाज नहीं आ रही पीछे नाथ की आवाज आ रही है बस
ओके आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू
फिर आपकी आवाज ही नहीं आ रही
नाउ कैन यू हियर मी
यस
ओके
फिर आप बताए क्या क्वेश्चन है
Tell me words or phrases which you will be using in this message, in this email address. You are going to write an email to a member of your family.
Hmm.
And you will be asking him or her that we are going to plan a get together or we are going to plan a family reunion. And we have selected this place, Kagan Valley. And you will be coming there, you will reach there at this date. So can you tell me words or phrases or sentences related to this? Think about
okay.
it. Okay, Zainab, I'm going to tell you because time is about over. Look at the screen I have written there. You will start like this. How are you? Dear cousin, dear uncle, or whoever the person is. You will, first of all, you will be writing, how are you? We are all ready for family reunion. You can see on the screen, how are you? We are all ready for family reunion. The place we have decided is Kagan Valley. We are going to plan it in the next month. It will be surely a wonderful occasion or event and a great chance for get together. We hope to see you on suppose dates. These are suppose dates. Saturday, 1st August 2020 or 2020. Join us at Kagan Valley. Your presence is requested at this reunion party. It will be a time to share old stories. It will be a time when we will be sharing old stories and we will be making a new memories. It will be a great memory if we spend time together at Kagan Valley. So bring your cam sneakers and camera and get ready for drilling. Let's revive. Revive mean make new. Revive mean refresh. The bond of love and togetherness. Love is among family members and togetherness with great excitement. So everyone will be excited there. Everyone will make it memorable. We will be having a lot of fun there. We will also go for boating and hiking and trekking. And the place that is decided, that is Kagan Valley. You are going to plan it next month. It will be a wonderful occasion, wonderful event, a great chance for get together. So date and day, you will also mention date and day, because on that day, that person will be reaching there, whichever you are going to tell him or her. So these are all the things. You can change these sentences or you can write your own sentences. Okay, beta? Okay, so it was all about email writing. You are going to have quick recap of it. Yes, email writing. It is in your book, student book. Open your student book. It's on page 83 of your student book. Beta, open your student book. It's on page 83 of your student book. Zainab, Ibra, Dua, page 83 of student book. Yashad, Maraj. Page 83 of student book. I'm going to ask Yashad. Okay, I'm going to ask Maraj.
Yes.
Maraj, please tell me. Can you see there is an exercise that is about writing?
Yes, miss.
Okay. So it is about email writing. And whatever you are looking at the screen, it is written here that you have to write an email to a member of your family. Give him details about your plans for a family reunion. And what is meant by reunion, I have already told you. This is the meaning of reunion, a planned gathering of family members. There are two types of email, informal and formal. Informal emails are written to relatives and friends. Formal emails are written for offices, for business purpose, or to authorities. This is the format of email. After from, you will be writing your email address. After from. And after to, you will be writing the email address of receiver to whom you are going to write an email. In subject, whatever the subject will be, like subject of this email is family reunion, then you will be writing subject here. Like this, salutation. Salutation is how you address other person. Dear cousin or dear uncle, etc. Salutation is how you address other person. Then you will be writing message, then closing, and then signature. So these are all the points which I have discussed. Okay, your homework is you have to write a